Hi everyone, welcome to my recital. Thank you all so much for coming. Yeah. It's gonna be a good program, and thank you to everyone watching on the live stream. I'm just gonna do a little bit of talking before each piece. So this first piece is Bach's Sonata for Viola da Gamba, number 2. It was written as part of a group of 3 sonatas for gamba. This is not a viola da gamba, this is a bass. The viola da gamba was a Baroque instrument with frets and 6 strings. It was played sitting down. In Bach's time, the bass didn't exist. So if we as bass players want to play pieces from that time period, we have to pull from other instruments. What is cool about this piece, as opposed to other Bach pieces that are often performed nowadays, is that it is accompanied. So in each movement, listen for some counterpoint between both the instruments. Thank you.
Thank you.
still works. So for our next piece, we are going to be playing Rossini's duo for cello and bass. Most of you, if you know Rossini, you would probably know him as a great composer of Italian opera, but there were a few pieces, such as this one, that he wrote that were not opera. Kind of the story with this one is Rossini was taking a visit to London, and a kind of English, like, noble family commissioned him to write this piece, and he kind of just threw it together in a night or a few days or something like that, and we ended up with a surprisingly standard part of the double bass repertoire. Kind of drawing from his Italian opera influences, there's kind of a comic element to this piece. I see it as kind of a tenor and a bass singer in dialogue in a lot of parts, and it has kind of a comic edge to it. So, hope you enjoy. hand. Nice. Hello again, everyone. Now we will be playing John Tartaglia's Fantasia for viola and double bass on themes by Marin Marais. Tartaglia was not a name that I knew before working on this piece. He was a 20th century violist with the Minnesota Orchestra and composer. And the story goes that a bass player in his section named William Trickle, he commissioned Tartaglia after hearing one of his previous pieces to write something on these themes by Marin Marais, who was a Baroque gamba player that he enjoyed. And the result was this piece, which premiered a few years later in 1987. And the way that he kind of handled the different themes was making it kind of like a stage play. There's these little scenes and then a transition and then to the next scene, and it kind of goes on. And there's a little bit of a recap at the end, and it's got a lot of character to each little section. So I hope you enjoy. Okay, so our last piece for the night is going to be Giovanni Battistini's second concerto for double bass. Battistini, a name probably only bass players will know. He was an Italian Romantic era composer, conductor, and most importantly, virtuoso bass player. He raised the level of what people thought was possible on the bass much higher than anyone before. He toured all over Europe and all over the Americas playing, and he wrote a lot of music for himself because he wanted to showcase everything he was capable of, highs and lows, fast and slows of the instrument. And now it has become one of the most, if not maybe the most standard piece of our repertoire. And for good reason, because not only does it show off the bass, but it also has a tremendous amount of character. Each movement, kind of similarly to Rossini, has a lot of operatic elements to it. And then the last movement is kind of just a big, fun dance. So thank you all so much for coming out tonight. It's really been a pleasure. And thank you all for everyone who supported me getting up to this point in the semester. It's been a long road, but a lot of fun. Thanks so much. Thank you.